tonight we are going to race through Genesis.
Uh-oh, my face.
Everybody ready?
Yes.
In the beginning, God created the heavens and the earth, shapeless and chaotic mass, with the Spirit of God looking over the darkness. Then God said, "Let there be light." Daytime and nighttime, this ended the first day. And God said,
"It is good.
It is good."
And then there was light. And God said, "It is good."
That ended the first day. Okay. Then God said, "Let the vapors separate to form the sky above and the ocean below." This ended the second day. And God said,
and what did God say?
It is good.
Then God said, "Let the water gather in oceans so that the dry land will appear," and named the dry land earth, and the water seas. That the earth first formed was grass and seed-bearing plant, fruit trees. Okay, listen. Fruit trees so they can seed so they can reproduce. This ended the third day, and God said,
"It is good."
Then God said, "Let there be a bright light to light the sky, to identify the day and the night, and the seasons of the earth. Sun for daytime, and moon and stars for nighttime." This ended the fourth day, and God said,
"It is good."
Those are doing great.
Then God said, "Let the waters fill with fish and other life, and the skies fill with birds. Multiply and fill the earth." This ended the fifth day, and God said,
"It is good."
Then God said, wait, let's watch this way. "Let the earth fill with every kind of animal." Then God said, "Let us make man in our image."
Oh, God.
Came from the earth, the dust came.
Hey.
Ouch.
Then he made woman.
He made.
"Multiply and fill the earth. And I give you all I have made and all the fruit trees for food, except for one tree, which will open your eyes to right and wrong, and you will die." This ended the sixth day, and God said,
"Amen."
Wasn't expecting that.
Finishing his task of creation, God ceased from his work and blessed the day and declared it holy and rested. This ended the seventh day.
That ended the seventh day.
Now the serpent, the craftiest of all, says to Eve. What does the serpent
say? No, you got one line before that, don't you?
"Really? God said you mustn't eat any, I don't know what kind one is that."
"You will not die. God knows that if you eat fruit of this tree, you'll be just as like
Really?
Eyes will be opened. You'll be
Then God says,
what have you done?
And sin enters the world.
Okay.
Adam and Eve had two sons, Cain and Abel. Cain was a farmer. And Abel was a shepherd. Cain offers a sacrifice to God. God was not pleased. Abel finds the best of his sheep and offers that as a sacrifice to God.
Delicious.
And God was pleased. Now Cain gets angry at Abel and kills him.
Oh my goodness.
Sin is in the world again. God banishes Cain from his land. And then Adam and Eve have another son named Seth. And this is the descendants of Adam and Eve.
From Adam comes Cain, Abel, Seth, Enosh, Kenan, Mahalalel, Jared, Enoch, Methuselah, Lamech, and Noah.
At this point, the earth becomes filled with sin. And God says to Noah,
Thank you.